Hello, this is Connie Belden, and we're going to take a look at the Chapter 4 practice problem and videos that's available in Module 4. On that page, you have both a link for an Excel file that looks just like this, and also a link for the videos, and I'll probably split it into several videos to kind of break it up. This first video being on the worksheet. So if you'd like to bring up the Excel file to work it with me, you can, or you can watch the video and go back and work it on your own. But what I have is the forms, and then followed by the answers for each section. So we're going to start with the worksheet. This is a 10-column worksheet, so we're taking a step backwards because the 10-column worksheet is done before the financial statements. Now, good news is, you already know how to do the first two columns. We did the unadjusted trial balance back in Chapter 2. Remember, we journalized, we posted to the ledgers, and then we developed the unadjusted trial balance. So that's actually the first two columns of our worksheet. So look at it this way, two columns down, eight more to go. The next two columns here in yellow are for the adjustments. So basically, we're going to take our adjustments and post each debit and credit, just like we wrote them as an adjusting entry. So as you're first learning the worksheets, the writing of the journal entry adjustments actually comes later in this cycle. However, I suggest you might want to write out those journal entries as you're first learning them so that you can see the debit and credit and post it, or put it, place it, I should say, correctly on the worksheet. Okay, so the first adjustment is supplies left in the storeroom, $4,000. That's how much is left. Your beginning balance in supplies is $500. So if you have $4,000 left, that means you used $1,000 worth of supplies. So let's skip ahead for a moment. I'm going to skip down. To how would you write that as an adjusting journal entry? You would debit supplies expense for the amount used of $1,000 and credit supplies for $1,000. So that's exactly the way I will put it onto the worksheet. So let me go to my worksheet. I will debit supplies expense for $1,000. So put that in the debit column. And then credit supplies for $1,000. So put that in the credit column. And again, notice I have an equal debit and credit amount, just like in my journal entry. Okay, now we're going to be a rental business here. So our revenue account is going to be rent revenue or rent income. So notice that we earned $5,000 this period of the unearned rent. So again, it might help to look at it as an adjusting journal entry like we did in Chapter 3 first. We would take it out of, or we would debit unearned rent and turn it into rent revenue. Okay. So let's go back to the worksheet. Okay. So I will debit unearned rent for $5,000 and credit rent income. Rent revenue, same thing, for $5,000. So again, I have an equaling debit and credit. C, wages accrued, but not billed. Sorry, how about wages accrued, but not paid yet? $500. So I will debit wages expense for $500 and credit wages payable, because that's exactly how I would write it out as an adjusting entry. By the way, notice I did not have supplies expense or depreciation expense in my initial trial balance, so therefore I added them to the bottom. Letter D. We've apparently rented a building to a company during the month of December, but we've agreed to delay them paying us till February 1st, so therefore we've earned it, we just haven't billed it yet. So remember, in this case, we learned in Chapter 3, we would just pretend like we are billing it. We would debit account receivable, and we would credit rent revenue. Now, notice this is my second credit entry to rent revenue. I had $5,000 from the one adjustment, and now $600 from this adjustment. So that really needs to be $5,600, but I'll write them in separately just so you can see where each came from. And the last adjustment, you always did debit depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation. Just make sure the accumulated depreciation is for equipment. So debit depreciation expense and credit accumulated depreciation that follows the equipment. Now, before you move on, double check yourself. You're going to add the debit and credit column. And you're going to make sure that each column balances. And I'll have to add this separate because I wrote it out separately. And each column in the adjustments balanced to $7,800. If not, you need to go back and see where you might have been off at. Did you forget a debit entry? Did you forget a credit? But just like with a journal entry, each adjustment has to have a debit and credit. And again, sometimes it's helpful to write it out as a journal entry to see which account you are debiting and which account you're crediting. Now, that's kind of the hardest part. From here, I will shade it in purple. You're going to combine the first four columns together. And just like when you're balancing a ledger, if you have a couple of debits, you add them together. If you have a couple of credits, you add them together. But if you have a debit and a credit, you have to subtract. Okay, for cash, all I have is a $40,000 debit, so I'll bring that over. For account receivable, I have $8,000 and $600, both debits, add them together. Now, for supplies, I have a debit of $5,000, a credit of $1,000, so I have to subtract. It stays on the debit side, the larger side, so I have $4,000, the amount that's left in supplies. Prepaid, bring that over. Equipment, bring that over. Now, for accumulated depreciation, I have a credit of $2,000 and a credit of $700. So I have a credit balance of $2,700. Bring over the auto. Bring over to the credit side the accumulated depreciation for the auto. Bring over to the credit side the accounts payable. Now, for wages payable, you have a credit of $1,000, a credit of $500. Bring it over to the credit side, add them together. Now, for unearned, you've got a credit of $12,000 and a debit of $5,000. So you do have to subtract it. Your $12,000 credit is larger, so it stays on the credit side, $7,000. Okay, bring over the stock to the credit side. Bring over the retained earnings to the credit side. Bring over the dividends to the debit side. Now, for rent revenue or rent income, you have three credits plus a $5,000 adjustment plus a $600 adjustment. So it's $29,600. And then bring your expenses over to the debit side. Okay, you have a debit adjustment to wages expense, so add it together. And bring over the expenses that you added to the bottom to the debit side. Okay, now you are going to total these together. I'll do an equal sum here. And I'll warn you right now, when we total them, they are not going to add up. Oh, I'm sorry, I take that back. They will add up. It's in the income statement. They will not add up. Sorry. This is now called the adjusted trial balance. And yes, they should add up. In this case, they both add up to $74,800. If they're not adding up, then you need to take a look at, did you maybe do a mathematical mistake incorrectly when you were adding your columns together? Therefore, then you might go back and check all of your math on those. Okay, now next, the income statement. Your income statement accounts are your rent income and your expenses. So I'm going to highlight those here in blue. So I'm only bringing over the ones in blue. This area up here will be left blank. all of your other accounts, and in this case you include dividends as well, that I'll highlight in green, will be brought over to the balance sheet columns. So therefore, from the numbers in purple, from your adjusted trial balance, you're going to bring it over to one of the last four columns. And you bring it over just like it is as far as debit or credit. So cash all the way through dividends come over to a balance sheet column. If it was a debit in the adjusted trial balance, just bring it over as a debit. Okay, so I'm bringing them all over as debits. The accumulated depreciation as a credit. The liabilities, bring those over to the credit side. Bring over common stock and retained earnings, and then bring dividends over to the debit side. Now, bring revenues over to the credit side of the income statement column, and bring your expenses over to the debit side. So all you're doing is bringing over the numbers exactly as is in the adjusted trial balance. Now, add your columns. Here's where they're not going to equal. And the reason being is the difference is going to be your net income. Okay, same thing here on the balance sheet columns. I'm going to add it together. Okay, they're not going to equal as well because the difference is going to be your net income. Now again, notice the area here and here is blank. Okay, next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to my blue, my income statement columns, and the difference between the two numbers that I'm highlighting in red will be your net income. Okay, your revenues total $29,600, your expenses total $5,200. So therefore, you will have a net income because your revenues are more than your expenses. And your net income should be on the debit side. Okay, I will take the difference between my revenues and my expenses. So I'll take $29,600 minus $5,200. And your net income is $24,400. Now notice that I put it on the debit side. Another way to remember it is put it on the smaller side. And then re-add. Go ahead and also re-add the credit column. Just pretend like there's zero here in the middle. So that way you can show that, and I'll put it here in bold and red. That way you can show that both columns now equal the same amount. Now, do the same thing over here. Take the difference in the two numbers from your balance sheet columns. So take $69,600 minus $45,200. And again, put the difference on the lower side. So if it's a net income, it's going to go on the credit side. And once again, you got $24,400. That has to match because you can only have one net income. Okay? If it doesn't match, check your math. You've done something incorrectly. Okay, just pretend like you're adding zero and bring that down. And then add those two together. Whoops. Let's try that again. Okay, and I'll highlight in red here. That way you could show that now both columns equal $69,600. Okay, so again, the worksheet can help you out in preparation of the financial statements. That's what we're going to look at here as we move on. But I will stop this video now, and that is how you do the worksheet. Go ahead and move on to the next video.